हेलो
हेलो हेलो हेलो
हेलो हेलो, कैन
हेलो
यू हियर मी सर? दिस इज बाबीता।
हेलो।
या ओके ना ओके यार, बट समटाइम्स वॉइस इज नॉट क्लियर।
बट आई कैन हियर यू प्रॉपरली यार, आई हैव नो डिस्टर्बेंस।
समटाइम्स आई एम गेटिंग सम डिस्टर्बेंस।
नाउ इज इट क्लियर?
या नो ओके, इफ पॉसिबल कम इन स्काइप।
या श्योर, आई डोंट थिंक मैं स्काइप
Because some voice is coming in this ear.
ओके। Can you send me your ID so that I can access it?
हेलो
या हेलो,
या नाउ ओके
या आई कैन हियर यू।
ओके ओके, आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू व्हाट इज द लैंडस्केप ऑफ एसएपी सिस्टम एंड व्हाट टाइप्स ऑफ प्रोजेक्ट्स वी हैव टू हैंडल एंड व्हाट इज एसएपी एफआई एंड व्हाट इज एसएपी सीओ। दिस काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू ब्रीफली। ओके,
ओके।
landscape of SAP system is depend on our business requirement because some companies are using development client, quality client and production client. Based on the requirements, we have to define the landscape of SAP system. For example, my client landscape is we have development client, quality client and pre-production client, golden server and production server. What is a development client? What is a quality client? What is a testing client? What is a pre-production? What is a golden server? And what is a production? I will explain you briefly, okay? About the development client is used for only configuration purpose.
ఒక
Hello?
మీటింగ్ వింటున్నా, ఒక క్లాస్ వింటున్నా, రావాలా? వస్తాను ఒక నిమిషం ఆగు, ఒక ఒక హాఫ్ అన్ అవర్. ఓకే. हेलो,
या
या
कैन आई कंटिन्यू? हेलो हेलो, कैन
या हेलो,
आई कंटिन्यू? हेलो,
हेलो,
या आर यू एबल टू हियर मी?
यस,
मैं कंटिन्यू और मैं स्टॉप?
नो नो, कंटिन्यू।
ओके ओके, एंड आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग यू अबाउट लैंडस्केप ऑफ एसएपी सिस्टम। हाउ एसएपी सिस्टम लैंडस्केप विल बी हैपन एंड व्हाट इज इम्प्लीमेंटेशन प्रोसेस। फॉर इम्प्लीमेंटेशन पर्पस वी आर फॉलोइंग वन स्टैंडर्ड मेथोडोलॉजी। व्हाट इज दैट मेथोडोलॉजी एंड आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट व्हाट टाइप्स ऑफ प्रोजेक्ट्स वी हैव टू हैंडल एंड व्हाट इज एसएपी एफआई एंड व्हाट इज एसएपी सीओ। नाउ फर्स्ट वन इज ए लैंडस्केप ऑफ एसएपी सिस्टम। The typical SAP system landscape is dependent on our business requirements. Means the landscape of system is different one client to, means one business to another business. For example, in my business I am handling three different projects. My business landscape is happen development client, quality client, pre-production, production and golden client. Okay, client nothing but a server, development server, quality server, pre-production server, golden server and production server. You should know about what server we are using, which server used for which kind of business activity, because if you go for live, we have to work on the server, which server we have to work, which server we have to do the testing, which server is used for user activities purpose. So first one is a development server. Development server nothing but a development client. Development client is used for configuration purpose, means all the implementation consultants will work on the development server. Means, for example, I am a FICO consultant, I will be work on the SAP, sorry, development server, I will do the all configuration in development server. After completion of all the configuration, I have to conduct one testing, that's nothing but a unit testing. What is a unit testing? Unit testing nothing but a individual scenario testing. Take for the example, do you know about foreign currency valuation, withholding tax, these kind of things?
Take for example,
you configure the withholding tax scenario. After completion of this scenario, you should know this scenario is working. So, due to that reason, we are conducting one test that is called a unit testing, individual scenario testing. For this one, we have to prepare one test script also. In development client, we have to do. After completion of all the configurations, this configuration can be moved from development client to quality client for testing purpose. What about the quality client? In quality client, what types of testings we have to do? These kind of things we should know. In quality client, we are conducting different kind of testings. In quality client, test consultants are working. Means if you go for big organizations like IBM and HP, their business will happen like this. If you go for small organizations, you only have to do the configuration, you only have to do the testing, you only have to do some companies also, you only have to move the transport request from one client to another client. But if you go for MNC companies, as a consultant, we have to work on the development client for implementation purpose, and we have to prepare the unit testing script, means individual scenario testing script, and we have to when we done the configuration, there is a transport request. That transport request we have to copy on that Excel sheet, and we have to inform to basis guy. The basis guy will move transport request from development to quality, quality to production, like that. Okay, here you should know about quality client. In quality client, testing consultant will be works. What types of testings will happen in quality client, I will explain you. In quality client, we will do different kind of testings. First one is unit testing, second one is integration testing, third one is regression testing, fourth one is stress testing, fifth one is user acceptance testing, sixth one is user training. First one is unit testing. Before I told you, as a consultant, after completion of the configuration, we should do one testing called a unit testing. Means individual scenario testing.
Each and every scenario testing.
Yeah, each and every scenario testing. Means, for example, withholding tax, we have to prepare test script and we have to do the testing. And we have two options. If you come tomorrow online, I will show you how test document will prepare. And in the test document, we have to take approval from business side also, because we feel we done testing fine. But after that, we need to sign on the document. We have to say, yeah, this is working fine. Then after, they will conduct user acceptance testing. What is user acceptance testing? Who works on the SAP system? Actually, end users works on the SAP system. They should have to accept this scenario is working. So we need to conduct one testing with users. That's nothing but a user acceptance testing. For getting the acceptance from your users, we are conducting this testing. Next one is integration testing. What is the integration testing? Integration testing means SAP is integrated with other sub-modules, like SAP integrate, SAP FI integrate with EMM. SAP FI integrate with SD. So in live scenario, what happened? As a FI guy, you do the only FI settings. As a MI guy, they do the MM settings. As a SD guy, they will do their settings. So how you know the document is flowing from FI to MM, FI to ST, these kind of things, we need to conduct one testing, that's nothing but integration testing. To know how the business document will be happen from FI to MM, means we need to post one purchase requisition, purchase order, goods received, invoice received, payment to party. This entire thing nothing but a FI MM integration, because purchase requisition is done by real-time MM user, and purchase order also done by MM side user, goods received also MM side user, invoice received, payment to party comes to FI side. So we need to conduct a testing entire this business scenario, then you should know, yeah, FI MM testing is working. Like this, for FI SD also we have to conduct testing. This is nothing but a FI SD integration testing. After completion of the integration testing, we have to conduct regression testing. What is a regression testing? A regression testing, in the sense, you have a two company codes. One is in India and one is in US. Okay. Sorry, within India you have two company codes, or within US you have a two company codes. My business
Hello?
Requirement is,
yeah.
Are you able to hear me?
Yeah.
Within India you have a two company codes. I am purchasing goods from company code 1 and I am paying money from company code 2. Means I have a purchase documents in company code 1. I have a payment documents in company code 2. So how can I auditor identify this is related to company code 1 payment and this is related to company code 1 purchase? So we have to give the account determination from company code 1 to company code 2. Then whenever you book purchases, or then whenever your payment made, the information can be shared with company code 1 2 and company code 2. So we need to do the account determination for this one. This is nothing but a regression testing. So we have to say how the documents flow. Hello. Are yaar.
Hello.
Vishali. Hello. Vishali. Hello.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can hear.
Hello.
Yeah.
May I continue? Hello, can I continue? Hello, are you able to hear me?
Hello.
Are you able to hear me?
Vishali? Hello, Vishali, can you hear me?
Both, but I don't know what is the problem from my end. Yeah.
Are you able to hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay. I will continue. About the regression testing, I will explain you what is the regression testing means. Cross company code business transaction testing, regression testing, nothing but a. For example, you have a two company codes, you purchased goods from company code 1 and you are making payment from company code 2. So we have to know how the document flow will happen company code 1 to company code 2. We have to give some account determination for company code 1 and 2 for document flow. So we need to conduct testing. This is nothing but a cross company code testing. In SAP terminology, it's a regression testing. Next one is a stress testing. What is a stress testing, in the sense, system performance testing. Means SAP, we purchase SAP based on the SAP user licenses. Some companies, they purchase 10 user licenses. They share this license to 50 members or 70 members. So then what will be happen? System performance will be low. So we need to conduct testing. When you are going to post any business transaction, how much time is consuming from as per your system, as per SAP standard time. So we need to conduct testing. This is nothing but a stress testing. Next one is user acceptance testing. I told you. Next one is user training. Why we do the user training? end user don't know about the SAP. Okay, end user don't know about SAP. We need to train them, then only they know. So we have to prepare the user manuals. If within India client, sometimes we go to client place for giving training. Sometimes we will give through some other tools. In end user training, we have to explain the user roles and responsibilities clearly. We have to take all the screenshot. Take for example, you are in the procure to pay process. Your user in the procure to pay process. So we have to take the all screenshots related to procure to pay. Means what is purchase requisition? For creation of purchase requisition, what requirements we have, and what is goods receipt, and what is purchase order, what is invoice receipt. These kind of documents we have to prepare, and we have to transfer this knowledge to user, and user can post the document. This is a user training. This is a landscape of SAP system. Next one is what types of projects we have to handle, and what is ASAP methodology. This is second one. If you go for as a SAP consultant, we have to handle different types of projects like implementation projects, rollout projects, and production support project. About the implementation project, for implementation project, we are following standard methodology. That's nothing but a ASAP methodology. What is ASAP methodology? ASAP methodology is used for to preparation of roadmap for implementation. The ASAP methodology consists of some certain standard phases. I will explain you all the phases. Based on these phases only, we have to do implementation ASAP. First one is a project preparation, business blueprint preparation, realization, final preparation, go live and support. This contains totally 5 phases. First phase is project preparation. What is a project preparation? Project preparation means we have to prepare one document. For example, you are a business, I am a SAP people. You know about your business well. I know about my SAP well. Actually, you are using no other than SAP project. You want move from that project, sorry, that tool to SAP tool. So, what you have to do? You have to purchase SAP from SAP India or SAP. After purchasing of SAP for implementation purpose, you have to tie up with some other companies. For example, you tie up with IBM. So what you have to do, as an IBM person, I don't know about SAP. As a business person, sorry, as an IBM person, I don't know about your business. As a business person, you don't know about SAP. So you have to prepare one document that's nothing but a as-is document. The as-is document describes about your business. Means in the as-is document, you have to say, yeah, my business is this. I'm using this kind of currencies. I'm using this kind of. I'm having this kind of company codes. My vendors' nature is like this. My payment terms is like this. My currencies are like this. You have to give all the information in the document. That's nothing but a as-is document. As-is document is a before implementation document. After completion of this as-is document, we prepare a to-be document. To-be document also before implementation document. What information we have to give, we give to us, with help of that information we prepare the document, that's nothing but a to-be document. The to-be document describes, yeah, if your company comes to SAP or if you implement SAP in your organization, your company comes like this. Means, I will show, yeah, you have 10 company codes, so you need to create the company codes, you need to create the plans, you need to create the these products, and if you post the document, flow will happen like this, and these kind of things support, these kind of things will not support, because SAP doesn't support all the business requirements. So, as per the business requirement, we need to customize the SAP for client business requirement. So, is there any gaps are there, these kind of things we have to explain. Gap nothing but a if client requirement is one, that requirement is not sufficiented by SAP, so we need to customize the standard SAP. Means we need to pick some standard tables and fields, we need to prepare one document. This document have to provide to ABAPers. With help of the ABAPers, we will implement that scenario. This is nothing but a gap document. So we have to understand, is there any gaps are there, and this is supports by standard SAP, and we have to prepare and we have to give this information to your business. This is nothing but a to-be document. With help of as is and to be document, we prepare the business blueprint. With help of the business blueprint, we will do the configuration in realization phase. Means, what is a realization phase? Before only I told to you, as a FICO consultant, we have to work on the realization phase. We need to configure the SAP system as per the business requirement. Means, in development plan, we configure the SAP. This is a realization phase. After completion of all the configuration, this configuration can be moved to development to quality, quality to testing, testing to pre-production, pre-production to golden server, and golden server to production. Like this, it will be happen. We do configuration in only one client. All the configuration can be moved with help of the transport request. This is about the realization phase. And final preparation. What is the final preparation? Before I explain you, when I explain you landscape of a system, that time only I explain you. The final preparation, we will do testings, unit testing, integration testing, regression testing, trust testing, and user acceptance testing, user training. All the things will be done in the final preparation. After completion of all the tasks, we feel, yeah, SAP configuration is completed. And we have to upload all the legacy system, legacy data balances uploading also completed. So, one second here, I'm getting call, okay? Hello?
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 Sir?
One second, I'm getting call, okay? Hello.
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay, okay. So, in final preparation, we will do all types of testings. After completion of all types of testings, yeah, we feel, yeah, SAP testings are completed, documentations are completed, user manuals preparation is completed, and all the legacy data, legacy balances also transferred properly. Then, we go for go live and production go live and support. What is the production go live? When all the things are completed, the SAP system is go for live. Means users can be started their business work. Sign off and sign in process is there. Based on that only we have to do all the things, because the business will give some time for configuration purpose, for testing purpose, for preparation of documents, all kind of thing. When go live date is there, we have to fix the go live date. On the date we have to go for live. When system is go for live, we don't do any testing directly in the production system. We don't conduct any configuration in production system, because if you've done any configuration or if you've done any testing in production system, it will be impact on our client business, because if you post any document in production, what will be happen? The transaction figures can be updated in P&L account and balance sheet. Their P&L or balance sheet will be some problem will happen. So we don't conduct any testing or we don't conduct any configuration directly in production system. Production system is used for only user business transaction posting purpose. While posting of the business transaction, if user got any error, the errors or the problems can be resolved by the support consultant. This is about the implementation process and rollout projects. What is a rollout project? You know about the rollout. Rollout nothing but a copy paste, because you have two company codes. One company code SAP configuration is completed. You have to do the SAP configuration to another company. So both company codes are belongs to you only. Some changes will be happen. Other than some changes, everything is same. So we have to take the standard company code details, and we copy and we paste, and like that we create. This is nothing but a rollout project. And third one is a production support project. What is a production support project? Production support in the sense, SAP configuration is when completed, when SAP system is go for live, everything is completed, system is running. After that, we have some period is there. On that period, we need to give free support. After completion of that agreement, the people have to give the project for production support to us or some other company. For example, they have give production support to some HP or TCS or Capgemini. So when system is go for production support, They handle only configuration changes, and they handle configuration changes, nothing but SCRs, and they will handle about if user got any errors, they will handle all kind of things. Again, will be come in production support. Means while posting of the business transaction, if user got any kind of issues that's related to configuration problem, that is related to customization problem, that is related to user mistake, everything will be resolved by the production support consultant. This is about our SAP projects. Then I will explain what is SAP CU. SAP FA, nothing but a financial accounting. This is used for external reporting purpose. And SAP CU, nothing but a costing controlling. This is used for internal reporting purpose, means management decision making purpose. In financial accounting, we have to discuss about general ledger accounting, accounts payable, account receivable, asset accounting. In controlling, we are going to discuss about cost element accounting, cost center accounting, profit center accounting, internal order, and some part of the COPA and product costing. And we have two integrations, FIMM integration, FISD integration. These things I will cover in SAP. And middleware, you want to know, go for SAP job now, and you have some knowledge in SAP, so I will show Azure document, how to prepare the Azure document, how to prepare the 2B document, what is a blueprint, how to prepare the test cases, and how to prepare the configuration documents, and how to prepare the configuration document while handling the user issues, what types of issues will be come repeatedly, how to resolve the issues, these kind of things I will explain in middle of the some classes. Okay.
Hello.
Do you have any doubts?
Okay.
Because can I close the call or can do you have any doubts?
Yeah, tomorrow I can. Yeah, the only thing is, can you give me your class? Can you give this class in night?
Sorry.
Is that possible for you? Is that
night?
Possible for
okay.
you to give
at
the
what
class
time?
At night time for you. For you, Vanessa. For you at. For you at 9:30 or 10 o'clock.
Night 9:30 10 o'clock in Indian time.
For you. Yes.
Not possible because I am working for the UK clients. My office timings are 2 to 11.
Okay then. Okay. I will email you with. Okay.
Okay. Fine. Bye. Okay. Bye.
Yeah. Bye.